played hard, did some good things for two and a half, almost three quarters, but the offense didn't do it, you know, our part. The offense is gonna take the ball, move it, get it in the end zone, and that's all on me. You know, I'm the one that calls the plays for the offense. I'm the one that's running the offense, and I got to do a better job. We've got to be able to get some consistency, get a good direction, and try to limit what we do and get better in practice this week. You know, I started out with Malik. Felt like the going into this game, he gave us some energy and some fire. He really wasn't able to execute in the first half. He tried hard. He ran hard. They did a good job with their plan on making sure the safeties knew where he was. And, you know, they tackled him well. Like, that was one of the things they did a good job of, was tackling him. And then, you know, he wasn't able to keep his focus downfield and see things in the passing game. So we felt at halftime that Juwan would give us a better chance for that. Juwan did see the coverages and did distribute the ball well at times, but we continually hurt ourselves. You know, we continually hurt ourselves with, you know, a big penalty when we're driving the ball to go in to score, when the game's nice and tight. We hurt ourselves with a couple other penalties and not snapping the ball a couple times. We had some drops and we had some interceptions, one in the red zone. So. We're just not very good right now on offense. We've got to get better, obviously, to have an opportunity to win games. So, but special teams is still holding their own, and they couldn't really give us the lift that we needed. But obviously, we are not a very good football team.
How do you see the quarterback situation moving forward?
Yeah, I think what we really need to do is grade this video and see where we're at and try to make a decision here, you know, Monday probably, and give us some direction on how we're going to go and what we're going to do. You know, it's hard to go back and forth, although a lot of teams are playing two quarterbacks, but we, you know, we really haven't had success playing two quarterbacks. We, you know, so we've got to work it out.
Seems like you guys have had that have had the question 3 weeks in a row. How do you, with either of the guys, whichever you decide to go with, how do you go about improving confidence at this point?
Yeah, the only way I know how to do is get on the field and work hard, you know, and throw good balls in practice, catch balls in practice, make plays in practice. You know, that's the biggest thing you got to do, is just get out there and improve and understand what's going on and get better at it. The teams I've coached in my career, we get better as the year goes on. So we got a lot of work ahead of us and a great challenge.
You said before that the guys in the locker room are still hung in there, but in the second half it seemed like you had fewer and fewer answers. How do you get them going again?
Yeah, I thought the defense competed hard and did a good job. We gave up a long post for a touchdown, which really hurt us. Offensively, you know, we just got to get it put together. You know, a football team, you're going to have ups and downs, and obviously right now we're on the downs, but we've got to stick together. That's one of the things football is the greatest team game that there is, so we've got to stick together and be a team.
Juwan seemed to throw a lot more of the intermediate and longer passes, whereas Malik, a lot of it seemed like it was shorter check down swing passes. Was that play calling, or was that the difference in the two of them seeing what was being called and what the defense was
doing? Yeah, I think it's a difference in seeing things downfield, you know, and we were trying to force the ball down the field a little bit. And Malik was trying to get it out of his hand quick. And like I said, at halftime, we felt like we weren't seeing some of the things that were going on down the field, which happens with young quarterbacks, you know, and they had a good plan.
One of the key series, I guess, of the game was after Rajay makes that interception, gets you down first and goal to three, had three cracks at it. What went wrong during that series, and how do you fix that?
Yeah, we felt like we were trying to run off tackle, and we had a couple good plays blocked. Our running back didn't quite get to the off tackle area. Cut back inside a couple times, and then we just weren't able to get it in the end zone. You know, and then it's like, okay, do I go for it on fourth down or kick a field goal at 6-0? My decision was to kick a field goal and get within striking, and we weren't able to get it done.
What did you see on Puma's interception? It seemed like he threw it in traffic.
Yeah, you know, the he thought that the receiver from the other side of the field was going to come open on the crossing route, and the corner did a nice job of turning his guy loose and coming off and playing the ball in the air. It was a good play by their corner. You know, they dropped eight guys deep on that. Sometimes you just got to get on to the next play.
Was Dorian out of it and CJ, were they not available?
Not available, no. Or Robert Hicks.
Your teams have always been so explosive offensively. Now this is pretty unusual. It's more than just a quarterback. When you analyze it, are there any other things that jump out at you?
Yeah, it's just killing us right now. You know, to not be able to be explosive and make big plays, throwing the ball, running.
Is it everywhere though? I mean, the line and the
yeah, players. it's offense is all 11 guys. You got to do your job, all 11 guys. All we can do is keep working on it, try to get better. But we have to get some explosive plays. You know, you can't just drive the football. You have to have big plays, and that's something that's really missing. You know, we have more big plays against Alabama than we have in the other games.